It was said later that Alexander was never defeated, except by Hephaestion's thighs.
Although an inferior race, the Persians control at least 4/5 of the known world. From Ethiopia and Egypt in the south, the Caucasus, and the two inland seas in the north.
Philip brought such as Aristotle from Athens to educate our rough people.
They rule, and we sit around like frogs.
Master!
Yes?
Master!
Yeah, well, out with it, out with it.
Why are the Persians so cruel?
Oh, come on, Neocos.
That is not the subject for today, Neocos, but it is true. The Oriental races are known for their barbarity and their slavish devotion to their senses, which are so dull they castrate young boys, such as yourselves, for their sexual pleasure. Yes. Excess in all things is the undoing of men. That is why we Greeks are superior. We practice control of our senses. Moderation. We hope.
Then what of Achilles at Troy, Master? Was he not excessive?
Achilles simply lacks restraint. He dominates other men so completely that even when he withdraws from battle, crazed with grief over his dead lover, Patroclus, he seriously endangers his own army. He is a deeply selfish man.
Then would you say that the love between Achilles and Patroclus is a corrupting one?
When men lie together in lust, it is a surrender to the passions and does nothing for the excellence in us. Nor does any other excess, Cassandra. Jealousy among them. But when men lie together and knowledge and virtue are passed between them, that is pure and excellent. When they compete to bring out the good, the best in each other, this is the love between men that can build the city-state and lift us from our frog pond.
But can a man love a woman equally, Master?
A woman? Of course not. A woman is a slave to her passion. Hephaestion. Oh, naturally there are exceptions, and we must honor them. Such as Pallas Athena, goddess of wisdom and war. But never forget, she is sprung not from the loins of Zeus, but from his mind. Now, you think on all this, my young frogs, for in you resides the future of Greek civilization. To strive for honor is the highest purpose of all. To rule over our baser emotions. To follow reason, the divine part in each of you. Yes, to love excellence is truly to love the gods.